Right guys, welcome to another video. On this video I will talk you through the steps required to create your own FM radio transmitter. So this is my second attempt. First attempt, let me show you the abomination I've done. I've done this one. It didn't work. You see the welding is far from professional. Plus, I didn't have these pliers, so when I did this one, this is a receiver, it's not a transmitter, but it never worked, right? So I said, okay, I'll give it another go. So I got this one now, an FM radio receiver and a transmitter, and I got this from eBay, as I did with this one, which, as I said, is not working. So I'll put this aside. Make sure you have all the welding, proper welding tools, which is okay. So I got this FM radio transmitter, and let me talk you through. So this is the what I've done. Probably you can't see it very good now because of the. But let me see if I can improve the quality a bit. Yeah. So this is the input. I have a phone, and I have a battery. Rechargeable batteries. So everything is pretty much straightforward, but you need to pay some attention on all the little components it comes with, especially the resistors. So I had five of them the same, as you can see here. The best practice is to put them in a row, right, and then use all these resistors. They come with a color, right? They're color coded. You can't see very well, I know, but so which side you're gonna put them, but what does matter is the you have to put the right resistor on the right place. This is a nice PCB because it tells the top. I don't like this camera. Sorry, it tells you the top which component goes where, and on the bottom you have all the welding. It's far from perfect, but it does the job. Now I'm gonna show you now. Range says 5 meters to 50. So I put the battery in. I put this this phone, right? This is my second phone. I have this is a buffing. That's the radio, right? This is so you see there's nothing here, and what is this? Did you throw an advert? Sorry about that. Let me find the one. Right, let's try to see, to play Kim Wilde. Is it gonna play? Oh no, it's not now. Here. This is the music. I know it does say 5 meters, and as soon as I take the antenna of the radio from the transmitter, that's better, right? Wow, and this is, it's not bad actually, but if I pause it, it stops. If I play, it plays, and you can adjust the frequency from this little knob, I think. So when you twist it, I don't know what's gonna go. Is it gonna go? I'll go the other way. I'm going the other way. I press play. I turn on the radio. We were here. Now let's here. Now I move to 80.5, right? That's the frequency. Before I was on somewhere else. Right, antenna is rubbish, as you can see. And this is the phone. Um, It does have a microphone. This is a microphone. This is the jack audio in. This is the LED, which is on. So as I said, I'm gonna try to increase the range. Be careful with LED. Make sure that you're gonna put the plus on the plus, the minus on the minus. Make sure you're gonna do the same with the capacitor. Extra, you must be extra careful on the resistors. Five of them, the 5K, were like the same. Then these two, managed to find them. And then I struggled with these three, so I had to go on Google, write down the colors, and try to match them up. And as I said, make some preparation on the make some preparation, make sure that you know where the components are, put some thinking on that, and then go ahead and take your time. So this is the radio. I'll see if I can broadcast like 50 or 60 meters. I see what the problem is. I have no clue what it is. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys.